This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.
Exercise, exercise, exercise. That's all you hear. Get off the couch, Trace. Come run with me, Trace. Here's what I say to you. Nope, because science says it might kill you. Hey there, avid runners and couch potatoes. According to science, you guys are basically the same. I'm Trace, thanks for watching DNews. In 1976, the number of marathon finishers was 25,000 nationwide. In 2013, it was 541,000. We sure seem to be running more than ever, with the number of races exploding. There were only 300 marathons nationwide in 2000. Now there are over 1,100. So is all this running an indicator of our nation's awesome better health? Not really. We're all told some exercise is better than no exercise, and in general that's true, but according to new research published in the Journal of the American College of Cardiology, too much of a good thing can often be too much to bear. According to the study, people who run at a fast pace, more than 4 hours a week, spread over 3 sessions or more, had the same risk of death as those who were sedentary and hardly exercised at all. Basically, sitting on your couch and doing nothing is unhealthy. Sedentary people risk heart disease, obesity, and other health problems. But running 240 minutes per week, or about 35 minutes a day, carries the same risk as sitting on your couch. That's shocking, I know. Jogging came onto the
scene. Jogging.
Jogging? That doesn't sound right. This avid running increased the mortality rate. According to the same study, though, it's easy to fix. Just run less and run slower. See, those who ran more than 2.5 hours in a week over 3 or more sessions at a fast pace had a mortality rate of 66%. But those who ran 1 to 2.4 hours a week in less than 3 sessions at a slow to moderate pace had a significant reduction in that mortality. In fact, light jogging has been shown to increase lifespan by 6.2 years for men and 5.6 for women. Okay, but before you go down into the comments to yell at us, scientists controlled for sex, age, medical history, lifestyle factors like smoking and alcohol consumption, and they followed almost 20,000 people for 40 years in this massive data set to learn all this stuff. They also use it to learn about a variety of other diseases like dementia and heart disease. According to their results, the graph is sort of an inverted U shape with inactive and overactive at the bottom. I immediately think of the benefits of coffee or wine, right? 1 8-ounce cup or glass is kind of okay, but more than that and the benefits decrease precipitously and you head into unhealthy behavior land. But as a runner, I wonder what is a slow to medium pace? What is that? According to one of the researchers, the pace of slow joggers corresponds to vigorous exercise, while the faster pace is very vigorous exercise. The doctor from UCLA, who wasn't part of the research, said that we weren't meant to mountain bike or marathon run every day. And this research shows if we want to live longer, we probably shouldn't do that. Other research states that long-term strenuous exercise, like marathons and triathlons, might harm the heart. But the risk is relatively low. Heart attacks among marathoners is lower or equal to athletes in other sports. But there is very little to gain by simply exercising more and more. This is in no way an attempt to dissuade people from running marathons or doing vigorous exercise. The benefits are there, and we have reported on them. But everything in moderation, as they say. And definitely never just sit on the couch. No way. People who are physically active have a 30% lower risk of death overall as opposed to those who aren't. So get off your butt for a few times a week and walk or jog or, you know, just do something. How does this make you feel though? Do you or someone you know exercise too much? Tell us about it down in the comments. Subscribe for more DNews and go ahead and share this video with them. It's real easy. And thanks for watching. This episode of DNews is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.